In this video, I'm going to show you how you can contribute to open source with CodeSandbox. I'm starting here in GitHub in an open source repository so you can see the connection between the open source repository and CodeSandbox. As you can see here in the URL, we have our organization and our repository. This is very similar to what it looks like if I were to open this up in CodeSandbox. I have P for projects, slash GitHub, and then the rest of the URL here. Now, this will work for any public repository where I can open this up and see the code running in CodeSandbox. Now, because it's a public repository, you likely only have read-only access to this. So what can happen is, depending on how the project is configured, it will look at the package JSON file to see if there's any tasks that can go into the dev tools, any previews that we can run up from the start for you. In this example, we have a preview that is already up and running. And so I could come around and look in the different files here. I could check out something from the code, or I could play around with the preview and see how this library is meant to be working. Now, if I want to play around with this, do anything more than observe this and see all the files, I could, you know, come in here and do some searches, what have you. But if I want to make any changes or really get my hands dirty and play around with this, I won't be able to because of my read-only access. Now, in a traditional context, I would then clone this and have this available in my local environment where I could open up a branch and play around. And we wanted to give that experience to you, but maybe even like an easier way possible. So if you come up here to the branch and click on the down chevron, you'll see that there's two options. The bottom one is the one you'll be most familiar with. This is the fork project, which we create a clone of the repository and put it into your account. So you'll have a new project in your personal projects. And you can open up a branch and play around with it, open up a PR. You can target that PR to your own forked repository or target the parent. Really something that is should sound a little familiar to most use cases. The contribution branch is actually the exciting bit that we created to make your life easier. So let me take you through this flow and show you how this works. So if I select create a contribution branch, you'll see that a branch is created off of this the repository. Now, what's notable about this contribution branch is it's not connected to any project on CodeSandbox. This is a CodeSandbox contribution branch that's basically a standalone branch. This means that if I were to make any changes to this, first I can because I have write access, but if I were to come in and do any, I'm just going to say a to-do thing here, I have read access to this. Now, if I were to take this URL and share it with somebody, they'd be able to see my changes as well. Now, if I want to make a commit though, I can't make a commit or a PR without having a project to reference. So we do all this in the background for you. All you have to do is come in, create a contribution branch, make your changes, see how it works, share it with somebody if you like, and as soon as you're ready to make a commit and save this, or even open up a PR, you come in, you make a commit, and that will allow you to open up a pull request if you would like. And what you'll see when you open up a pull request is in the background, this doesn't show up on your dashboard or anything, in the background you'll see that there is a project or repository that's attached to my account that is referencing this branch here, which is the contribution branch. So the idea is that once you make your changes, all you have to do is create a PR. It will target the parent or the original open source repository, so you can make this request for a change or suggestion to the community, and they can take a look at this. And you don't have to finagle with any of the branches and projects targeting the right things. We take care of that for you. Now, if I were to come into my dashboard, you would see that I have my open source contributions, and this here indicates that this is just a contribution branch. This isn't a project. I won't have multiple branches attached to this. It's a standalone contribution branch that will show up in the Kanban board for the open source maintainers so they can review it and give you feedback or merge it in, and you can continue on with your open source contribution journey.